My name is Michaela Guerrero. I am 15 years of age. I attend at Pleasantville Secondary School and I am from Moruga. Growing up in Moruga, you know, is more country-wise, you know, so, you know, more outdoor activities, you know, like climbing plum tree, climbing mango trees, you know, more outdoor on the beach, learning how to swim, you know. Normal kids nowadays wouldn't, you know, be more exposed to that kind of lifestyle. And, you know, I'm just grateful to have the things that I have from Moruga. Like, I eat yam, like, lots of provision, you know, wild meat. And maybe one day I can invite you guys to come and eat some wild meat with me in Moruga. I had started off doing track and field, long distance runner, for my primary school, which is Princeton Presbyterian number one, right? And then in Moruga, I grew up around mostly boys who played football. And I was like, well, I want to play too. I don't want to be left out. Then I just pick up this passion and love for football, and I just roll with it. And then I was introduced to the G League, where I was eventually scouted to play for the national program.
When you got the news that you were selected for high performance, how did you feel about that?
I was elated.
I got the email that she was selected, and I didn't say anything. I like surprises. So she came in about 7 after working out, and she was like, Mommy, let us run. I said, really? She said, say anything? I said, no. She said, you sure? I said, no. She said, look, sir, look. She went back. She told the other teammates because they were asking. And she became worried, and you know, she just went in her zone. I said, what happened? I keep checking on her, walking back and forth. She said, nothing. I said, nothing. So I was getting ready for work. So I keep watching her and things. She was like, you know, tears in her eyes. I said, I thought you were worried. And you tell me you sure make any team here? She, well, anything could happen, you know, because now you're seeing and I worried. I said, okay then. So when it was like 8 o'clock, my sister them came. And I walk outside and I said, call her. So when I call her, now I'm ready to go. And I was like, Michaela. She said, what happened? I said, come. And she happened. I said, you got you. You look the letter. And she was like, you see what you think? You know, girl. I say yes, you know. And I said, no, girl, I had it before. And she was really, really, she didn't, you know, control her. She couldn't control herself after that, you know. She
cried tears of joy, to be honest, because I wasn't expecting that opportunity. And now that I got it, now I started to be the opportunity, and you know, more opportunities open up to me. I would have to thank an old coach from Moruga. His name is Andy. He made me actually the player I am today. He helped me with all the gears. I didn't really know what I had to get for football. He helped me out a lot. He carried me to my first international screening for the under 17 women's. I did not make it at first, but I did not give up. There are two people I mostly count as my role model, which is my dad and Coach Marlon. You know, they're so humble, you know, they teach me most of my life lessons, you know, and it just be me being me. I pick up after them, and I just feel like that just making me a great, good, kind-hearted person that I am today, and I follow in their footsteps, but on my own beat. Good times was, you know, meeting this team, you know, eventually. I used to think of them as friends at first, and now everyone just become one big family, and now I start to think of them as sisters, where I love them to my heart. Last year, we went to the CFU, we represented at the CFU Cup in Antigua. Eventually, we was knocked out by Aruba in the semi-finals. And it was a lot of sorrow, right? And one thing we did was we held each other up and we just moved forward, and we want to use this tournament as our stepping stone from Antigua. Being a young ambassador is great, obviously, because, you know, not really boasting to my friends, but the younger ones, I am influenced by elders, and you know, there are younger ones influenced by me, right? And seeing that I have influence on people's lives just makes me a happy person and make me want to better myself more. Outside of football, I personally like to, you know, do poetry. I love writing because I can't really speak about my emotions. I don't like speaking about my emotions to anyone. So I feel like, you know, I could just write it in poetry or spoken words, and I feel like I understand myself better and could like more describe how I feel through poetry. So personally, I think that, you know, it's not hard to do the right thing, you know, but you know, the leaders need to more comfort and put their foot down, that we're trying to make it be a change, and the change can start with us. As young individuals, we want to be a leading group as well. We want to make that change, right? My very first favorite footballer, right, it was a boy. And now I would like for any younger female footballers to look up and be like, that girl, I want to be just like her, you know, influence on them, you know, so we can have that equality and, you know, in the women's football. That boy was Cristiano Ronaldo. I am personally elated. You know, I get to represent my country. You know, I get to play in my country where all my friends, families, and everyone would be attending. And I just want to perform to the best of my ability, you know, to show the whole of Trinidad that we are representing for them and that, you know, we are there. I would like to encourage you, citizen of Trinidad and Tobago, to come out and support the girls under 15 in the National CONCACAF tournament.